finding the value of this integral over here is tricky, but it's not the hardest part of this exercise. There are many hidden pitfalls here. Can you avoid all of them? Try to compute it yourself first, including all steps, and then look whether you dealt with all difficulties properly during this video. So we have a function, x times sine x divided by x to the power of 4 of plus 5x squared plus 4, and we want to compute this integral using some complex function. Well, first, could we use an fz including some sine of z? Well, if you would use a sine of z, you get into trouble, because the sine of z in complex sense blows up if you go to in the upper half plane up or in the lower half plane down. So you will never be able to use an ML estimate or Jordan or something like that. So we have to prepare a bit. We have to do a small trick. So what do we do? Well, first we integrate from 0 to r, and then we use the symmetry. This function is symmetric, so the integral from 0 to r equals the integral from minus r to 0 is equal to 1 half of minus r to r. So that's first we use the symmetry in the first step. And then we know, hey, this sine of x equals the imaginary part of e to the power ix. So we can take this imaginary part out, and then we have this function over here. And now we have an e to the power ix. So why do we do that? Because with the e to the power ix, if we are going in the upper half plane, this e to the power ix, that one will not blow up if you take an e to the power iz for our f of z. We'll see why later on. So we define our e to the power our fz as z times e to the power iz divided by this numerator here, but now z to the power 4 plus 5 times z squared plus 4. And we have our contour consisting of cr and lr, so that's our contour c. And we want to compute the integral of f along c. So that's the first step. Second step, I want to use the theorem of residues. So we have to find all singularities of f of z. So we have to solve for this fourth order equation. Well, actually, we have to set this one to 0 and solve for it. So what do we do? We set z squared equals p. And then we solve for p, and we find z equals plus or minus 2i or plus or minus i. You can do all those steps yourself. Write them down, of course, in your own solution. So where are those singularities? Well, we have the plus or minus 2i and the plus or minus i. And you see that only 2i and i are inside the contour. So f of z is analytic on an inside C. Except at z equals I and z equals 2i, where we have simple poles. That means that we can apply the theorem of residues. The integral along cfz dz equals 2 pi I times the residue at I plus the residue at 2i. Now, can you compute residues? Well, for example, you can factorize the denominator, and then you can compute residues easily. Do this for yourself, yourself, of course, on your own solution. And then you have the residue at 2i and the residue at I. And then you have the integral along all of CR equals 2 pi I times the sum of those residues over here. End of step 2, application of the theorem of residues. On to step 3, we parameterize here the LR. Well, that's easy in this case. We can just use as parameterization z equals x. And we integrate from minus r to r, and our function becomes x times e to the power ix divided by x to the power 4 plus 5x squared plus 4, which is exactly what we have over here, of course. That's what we want to get. Now we want to get rid of the integral along cr, the integral along the big circle. Now, can we use the ML theorem or Jordan, or would both of them work? Or none of neither of them. Let's see what happens if we try to use the ML theorem. It's a bit cumbersome, but it will do. The ML theorem says that if the norm of z is less or equal than mr on cr, then the norm of the integral along here of f, and this are equal then mr times lr. So first we need to estimate the norm of f of z, which is a bit of a mess. The numerator is easy. The norm of z times e to the power iz equals norm of z equals r, e to the power iz equals e to the power ix plus iy, and you get an r times e to the power minus y. And now y is positive. So this e to the power minus y is at most 1. So this is less or equal than r. And that here is where you need the e to the power iz. If you would have a sine of z, you also would get an e to the power y here, which blows up and you are lost. So if you did that wrong in your first step, you should realize that at this point that something goes wrong, and of course go back and correct everything. Yeah? So that's the numerator. Now what about the denominator? For that we can use a few triangle inequalities. Norm of z to the power 4 plus 5 z squared plus 4 is greater or equal than first part minus second part, and then absolute values around it. Now we want to get rid of those absolute values. Now how do we do that? Now for that we'll show first that this part is greater than the 4. Now how do we do that? So we need a step in between. Well, the norm of z to the power 4 plus 5 z squared is greater or equal than norm of first part minus norm of second part, and then absolute values. Reverse triangle inequality. Now we are on CR, so the norm of z to the power 4 is r to the power 4, and the norm of 5z squared equals 5r squared. Now, furthermore, we will take r to infinity, so r will become very, very big. So r to the power 4 becomes much, much bigger than 5r squared, so this equals r to the power 4 minus 5r squared, and again, we will take r very large. So this will be greater or equal than 4. So that means that those absolute value signs here disappear because this first part is greater than the second part. So the difference is positive. So that's finally we've gotten rid of our absolute value signs, and this inequality here for this one can now be reused, unfortunately. So this is greater or equal than r to the power 4 minus 5r squared minus 4. So you see, it's quite a messy estimate. But then we have our MR. If you combine the estimate for the numerator and the estimate for the denominator, you have that the norm of f of z is smaller or equal than r divided by this part here, and we call this MR. Then we use the ML theorem. Of course, the norm of the integral is positive, and also less or equal than pi r, length of CR, times MR, which we have over here. Then you can compute this limit over here. And you show that it's equal to 0. Do this, of course, in your own solution, for example, by dividing by the highest power or any method you like. You have to show something here. Then you can use the squeeze theorem. So if you take the limit r to infinity, the limit of this norm equals 0, and you can conclude that limit r to infinity of the integral along CR of f z dz equals 0. Boom. End of step 4. So we can get rid of the integral along the big arc. And then step 5, combine everything. Integral minus r to r plus integral along CR equals 2 pi r times the sum of the residues. Bring this integral to the right hand side and take imaginary parts. That was what we do over here. So here we've also taken the imaginary part of this. It's purely imaginary, but okay. Then we can simplify a bit, take the imaginary part here inside, you get a sine of x. And then we take on the left and right the limit r to infinity. Now, on the right-hand side, this limit exists. Here, there's no r. And we have shown in step 4 that the limit r to infinity of this complex number equals 0. So also, limit r to infinity of its imaginary part equals 0. So the limit exists, so you can split it up in parts. And on the left-hand side, there you have to be a bit careful. And there we get the principal value of this integral minus infinity to infinity. And this one drops out, so this is what you get on the right-hand side. Now, how do we get rid of this principal value? Now we have a symmetric function over here, an even function, which means that the principal value of the integral is the same as the integral minus infinity to infinity over here. And this integral from minus infinity to infinity was one half times, the integral from 0 to infinity equals 1/2 times the integral from minus infinity to infinity. So the integral from 0 to infinity in the integral we were looking for equals pi over 6 times e to the power minus 1 minus e to the power minus 2.